Good morning, dear students. Welcome back again with a new lesson of study of sound, which you have already started. We have discussed about sound, different ranges of sound, if it is audible and unaudible, or we can say that if the frequency is less than audible, it is called infra, more than the range of audible, it is called ultra. And the range of hearing sound, which we call it as audible, that is from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. That we already studied. And we also discussed about the uses of ultrasonic sound. Now today we are going to start with the new subtopic, that is reflection of sound. Now reflection of sound can take place through various media. Through solid, liquid, as well as through the gases. Let's see how and with what examples they are trying to explain to us. Like light waves, sound waves too get reflected from solid or a liquid surface. These waves also follow the law of reflection. The smooth or a rough surface is needed for the reflection of sound. The direction of the incident sound wave and the reflected sound wave make equal angles with perpendicular to the surface, and all the three lie in the same plane. So this is the law of reflection, that incident ray and reflected ray, they lie opposite to the normal, and all three points, all three incident ray, reflected ray and normal, they all three lie in a same plane. An angle of incident is always equals to angle of reflection in case of law of reflection. Now, good reflectors and bad reflectors of sound. How much of the incident sound get reflected decides whether the reflector is a good or a bad reflector. The hard and the flat surface is a good reflector, while clothes, paper, curtains, carpet, furniture, etc. absorb sound instead of reflecting it, and therefore they are called as bad reflectors. So you have got the example of good reflectors and bad reflectors. Good reflectors, the hard substance, that is called good reflectors, and softs, and you can say unplane, or you can say rough surface, they are called as bad reflectors because they have tendency to absorb the sound. Since they absorb it, they do not reflect 100%. Now, another term in the field of sound is echo. Echo is what? Reflection of sound. You must have visited to echo point at a hill station. If you shout loudly at such a point, you hear the same sound just after a little while. This sound is called as an echo. The same sound is reflected back within a few seconds. An echo is a reflection of the original sound because the reflection of same surface. In order to be able to hear the original sound and its reflection distinctly means separately, at 22 degrees Celsius, what must be the minimum distance between the source of the sound and the reflecting surface? So in order to hear the reflecting sound, what should be the minimum distance between source and the reflecting surface? That we have to calculate it with the help of the formula which you already studied in the lower section. Let's see how it is being calculated. At 22 degrees Celsius, the velocity of sound in air is 344 meters per second. Our brain returns the sound or retains the sound for 0.1 second. So we have the ability to hear the words clearly if the words are repeated after 1/10 of a second. If the words are repeated within 1/10 of a second, we may hear the sound, but we may not be able to hear the words very clearly. and therefore the retention of sound, time for the retention of the sound or to be able to hear the words very much clearly is 0.1 second or we can say 1/10 of a second. And the velocity of sound in is 344 meter per second. So with the help of this information, we can find out the minimum distance required for the echo, minimum distance required for the reflection of sound, or minimum distance required that is between the source of sound and the reflecting surface. Thus, we can determine the minimum distance between the source and the reflecting surface, which are as follows. Distance equals to speed into time, which you already studied. Speed, we know it is 344 meter per second, and time is 1/10 of a second, that is 0.1. So after multiplying it, we get 34.4 meter. Thus, to be able to hear a distinct echo, the reflecting surface should be a minimum distance of half of the above, that is 17.2 meter. Because this distance is distance traveled by the sound from the source of the sound to the reflecting surface, from the reflecting surface again back to the receiver. So therefore, the total distance required between source of the sound and the reflecting surface should be approximately half of it. And therefore, the total distance required in order to hear the echo is 34.4 divided by 2, that is 17.2 meter. Now, as the velocity of sound depends upon the temperature of air, this distance depends on the temperature. Now, another term comes out, that is reverberation. Now, what is reverberation? That we'll see it here. Sound waves get reflected from the walls and roof of the room multiple times. This causes a single sound to be heard not once but continuously. Means one sound is repeated again and again. It reflects many times and the same sound is repeated after regular interval. And therefore we are unable to hear the words very much clearly. This is called as reverberation. The time between the successive reflection of a particular sound wave reaching it becomes smaller and reflecting sound get mixed up and produce a continuous sound of the increased loudness which cannot be deciphered clearly. This is the reason why some auditoriums or some particular seats in the auditorium have inferior sound reception. This is shown in the figure 12.3. So that multiple reflection take place and we should be able to hear the sound very much clearly. So in order to avoid reverberation, a plain reflecting surface has to be kept so that we can hear the sound even after multiple reflection. Now, reflection of sound in the water, in the ship, with the help of ultrasonic sound. And therefore, simple form, here they have used a shortcut word that is called sonar. Sound navigation ranging. SO implies sound, NA implies navigation, and R represents ranging. Sonar is a short form for the sound navigation and ranging. It is used in determining the distance, and speed of a underwater object with the help of ultrasonic sound waves. Sonar has a transmitter and a receiver. As well in the diagram, you can see the transmitter as well as the receiver, which are fitted in the ships or boats. The transmitter produces and transmits the ultrasonic sound. These waves travel through the water, strike the underwater objects and get reflected by them. The reflected waves are received by the receiver on the ship. The receiver converts ultrasonic sound into electrical signals, and these signals are properly interpreted. The time difference between transmission and reception is noted. This time and the velocity of sound in water gives a distance from the ship of the object which reflects the waves. So this way we can find out the depth of the sea, or if any object is found, different objects lying under the water can be easily found with the help of the reflection of sound in the water. Sonar is used to determine the depth of the sea. Sonar is also used to search underwater hills, valleys, submarines, icebergs, sunken ships, etc. Now, sonography. Again, another important application of sounds. That is sonography. Now, what is the use of sonography? We have heard about the sonography. Used to find out the internal structure of the body with the help of the ultrasonic sound, which makes images on the screen and help us to find out what is the actual position or what is the actual structure present inside our body. Sonography technology uses ultrasonic sound waves to generate images of internal organs of the human body. This is useful in finding out the cause of swelling, infection, pain, etc. The condition of the heart, the state of the heart after heart attack, as well as the growth of fetus inside the womb. Fetus is undeveloped child inside the womb, that is called fetus. The fetus inside the womb of a pregnant woman are studied using this technique. The technique makes the use of the probe and the gel. The probe, one terminal of the wire is there, and gel. Gel is applied on the skin. The technique makes use of the probe and the gel. The gel is used to make a proper contact between the skin and the probe so that the full capacity of the ultrasound can be utilized. The gel is applied on the skin outside the internal organ to be studied. High frequency ultrasound is transmitted inside the body with the help of the probe. So through the probe, ultrasonic sound is entered or allowed to pass through it, and gel will make the contact, clear contact between the probe and the skin, so we can make the optimum utilization of the ultrasonic sound. The sound reflected from the internal organ is again collected by the probe and fed to a computer, which generates the images of the internal organ. And this is the method, as this method is painless, is increasingly used in the medical practice for correcting the diagnosis. Now, this part of is omitted for the syllabus, so we'll move to the next part, that is human ear. Now, by studying the human ear, the diagram should be very much clearly presented in front of you. So, you have to be very much precise with the diagram and the description. Both should be done together. Then only you can understand the explanation properly. The ear is an important organ of the human body. We hear sound because of our ear. When sound waves falls on the cerebrum or eardrum, fall on the eardrum, it vibrates. The vibrations are converted into electrical signals which travel to the brain through the nerves. The ear can be divided into three parts: outer ear, middle ear, and the inner ear. So here three parts are there: outer, inner, and the middle ear, through which the sound passes. Now, how do we actually hear it? Because the sound travels and strikes the eardrum. When the eardrum vibrates through the eardrums, it is connected into electrical impulses, and then the message is transferred to the brain, and then we can hear the sound. Now, three parts we have studied. We will study each part one by one. The outer ear or pinna. The pinna or outer ear is there in each and every human body as well as other animals also. The use of this pinna is to catch the frequency of the sound. The outer ear collects the sound waves and passes through a tube to a cavity in the middle ear. The peculiar funnel-like shape forms to collect and pass the sound into the middle ear. So, a funnel-like structure is formed with the help of the ear pinna, which allows the sound to enter into the middle ear. Once the sound enters the middle ear, there is a membrane in the cavity. Cavity means a hole-like structure is there. Cavity of the middle ear called as eardrum. So, eardrum is there, which can easily vibrate. It is very sensitive. It can easily vibrate when a frequency of sound is being heard. So, that is by alternate compression and rarefaction. So, when a compression in a sound waves reaches the eardrum, the pressure increases and it gets pushed inwards. The opposite happens when rarefaction reaches there. So, when compression is there, eardrum moves inwards, and when rarefaction is there, eardrum moves outwards. So, alternate compression rarefaction is there, due to which alternate vibration take place of the eardrum. And this vibration of the eardrum help us to create electrical signals and which help us to send this message to the brain. The membrane gets pulled outwards. The sound waves cause vibrations to the membrane. Now, the inner ear. The auditory nerve connects the inner ear to the brain. The inner ear has a structure of resembling the shell of a snail. So, inner part of the ear is just like a snail. It is called as cochlea. The cochlea receives the vibrations from the membrane and converts them into internal signals which are sent to the brain through the nerve. The brain analyzes these signals. As the brain analyzes these signals, we can hear the sound. Thus, the process of hearing the sound is completed. Now, based on the formula, certain sums are there, solid examples are there, which I expect that you can do it of your own. Now, relevant to it, if any doubt is there, you are free to ask. Here we have completed this lesson. For the next lesson, we'll move to the next video, which will be taken next time. Till then, have a great day.